Good morning, everybody, and wish you all a happy Scouting Sunrise Day and World Scarf Day. On this occasion of Scouting Sunrise Day, I am sure definitely every one of you have taken a oath in the morning at 8 a.m. If anybody has not taken an oath, it is never late. We can still take an oath now. We can renew our promise and also take a pledge to fight the deadly pandemic COVID-19. On this auspicious note, I welcome our State Chief Commissioner, Mr. P.G.R. Sindhya, who is also the Secretary General of President in Council, to the studio. And I'll also welcome our speaker, resource speaker of the day, Mr. Krishna Swami, Executive Director of Bharat Scouts and Guides. I welcome both of you for this webcast. To begin the proceedings, I request our State Chief Commissioner, Sri P.G.R. Sindhya, to give the opening remarks. Sir, for you for the opening remarks.
Namaskar to everybody. I salute everybody on this happiest occasion of World Scout Day, and also today is a very holy day. For the reason, a great personality of the world, Baden-Powell, took few boys with him and started a camp and shared with his experience of his life in the army and otherwise with the youngsters for 10 days, and he started teaching them life skill. That was in the year 1907 in the Brown Sea Island of England. That day, the sun of the scouting started rising. That is why we call it as Sunrise Day of the Scouting. So our sun is eternal, as all of you know. Without sun, without earth, without water, without air, none of us can live. Sun is the truth. Sun is the God. All religions on this planet, we respect the sun. Look at the meaning, how it has been given by our elders. Sunrise Day, that is Scouting Rise Day, it is called as. Scouting Rising Day. I am very happy that this movement has risen for 100 years. We have more than 100 years we have lived. And we have to live for hundreds of years to come. And sun keeps on rising for millions of years. Shining. So friends, it's a very holy day for that reason. Rightly, this has been named as Scouting Sunrise Day. On the same day, we wear a holy scarf also. What is the meaning of the scarf? The scarf is for world peace. It is for humanity. It is for everybody. And this represents not only friendship, it also represents help. Scouts are meant for helping others. On this day, we are conducting this seminar and we are participating. We should be very lucky to participate on such a holy occasion. I congratulate Madhusudan and his friends. Our Deputy International Commissioner, Madhusudan, is a very dynamic personality in the scouting world in India. I also extend a warm welcome to the most dynamic executive director, Mr. Krishna Swami, who has given his life for the growth of scouting in India. There are very few people who are dedicated as professionals for the ideals and the cause of the scouts and guides. So friends, in the morning today, I got up early morning, got ready myself with my young friends Chandru and Suprit Balaji. I took a oath. I renewed my scout promise. I also took a oath that during the pandemic period of COVID-19, which is a world crisis, that I will abide by whatever the government of India, the state governments, the health departments, and the World Health Organization, whatever restrictions they have put, whatever advice they give to us, wearing a mask, keeping social distance, washing our hands, telling our friends about spreading of COVID-19 and how to stop it. These are certain things I have taken a oath that I will stand to prevent further spread of COVID-19, which has caused havoc on humanity. With these few words, I am sure Mr. Krishnaswamy, our executive director, is a very well-informed person who must have seen Bronte Island and who has given decades for the cause of the growth of this scouting movement, scouting spirit, will let us know about the other aspects of this holy day. For the last 4 months in India, many youngsters are doing great service to the human beings, whether it is distribution of food, whether it is distribution of food grains, or it is awareness of COVID-19 and its effect, serving in the laboratories, serving to the people, serving to the governments, at the direction of the district collectors. They have done a wonderful job, Scouts and Guides, as an organization in the entire country, particularly in Karnataka. More than 2,000 volunteers are working from the day one. More than 10,000 volunteers working whenever the government gives us a call. So totally, we have also conducted many educative webinars covering personalities of the countries like Infosys former chairman Narayan Murthy, Bharata Vibhushana, Padma Vibhushana, Rutam Narasimhan, many personalities have participated in these webinars and they have told so many things to our youngsters. They have given their experience of their life. They have shared with the youngsters. In the days to come also, we have no option but to do all these things online. I am sure all of you will do a good turn today because it's a stop day. I've already introduced the young man who is going to be an asset to this organization. Hope all of you will do it. With these few words, I take this opportunity to greet all of you. I say, happy Scouting Sunrise Day. I also say, happy Scout Day. I also say, wish you all the best. Thank you very much. Thank you, Matsudan.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your brief introductory words. Now it is time to move on to know and revisit the first experimental camp. Now I give it to Mr. Krishnaswamy R, our executive director.
First of all, let us thank our mentor, Sri PGR Sindhya sir, for continually keeping us busy with valuable guests and input speakers from across the walks of life to be active during this pandemic when we are at home. Today, the 1st of August is considered to be the Scouting Sunrise Day for a simple reason that Lord Baden Powell could bring 22 young people to the Bronte Island in Plymouth Old Harbour in England. Now, the team of our friends, we worked out on documents and the authenticity of the documents which we wanted to present to you during this webinar, we will be presenting the authentic document to see that how the Scout movement has
taken into a shape of a big tree covering the entire world today and has proved how worthy it is. When we speak of the worthiness of young people, the pandemic COVID has proved how worthy each member who took the promise to do his or her duty to God, her country, and to help other people. Many of us must have seen a newspaper cutting coming from the United States of America. A young girl guide belonging to Andhra Pradesh receiving the commendation from the President of the United States of America. See, the Brownsea Island camp, if it was not happening in 113 years back, or if Lord Baden Powell thought of his achievements in the armed forces to be on his crest in the form of some medals or commendation received from the Majesty, the Queen and King of England, and to keep all his knowledge for himself. But the story of Brownsea Island will also lead to tell us how friendship works in scouting than the value for money or the wealth that people have created. Let's see from the story which is on your screens now. Let's see the first part of this. When we see this, Lord Baden Powell met two people of the elite community in England who invited him to visit Brownsea Island as their personal guest. It may be their admiration to the achievements of Lord Baden Powell that made them to invite him to their private property, which is in the Brownsea Island. But how a visionary man took advantage of this property to be an experimental ground for how he can serve the entire world community through making young boys worthy to be called as such. When we go to the beginning of the story of the Brownsea Island, this is when the first time BP wrote the words scouting for boys in a letter to his old army friend to tell him about his ideas to experiment his experiences in India and Africa to be best used for the young people. How the young people can be brought together and trained in a systematic manner. And as we always speak of the life skills that Lord Baden Powell wanted to share with the young people so that in peacetime they can be useful to their country, their families, their friends, and the society as a whole. He wrote to his friends to come down and help him in the management of the first experimental camp which he wanted to organize. If you go through the document, you can see that Baden Powell never wanted to experiment his ideas on an elite group of young boys who were well nurtured in their family culture or who were supported with good living backgrounds. He insisted that he should have a cosmopolitan group of young people from different backgrounds participating in his camp. He wrote to his friends in the Boy Scouts Brigade of England to get young boys of different backgrounds to be part of his experimental camp. And he also invited his friends who can contribute from their experiences in taking up this experimental camp to a success. Resource generation is an art, and it also needs a vivid thinking. Lord Baden-Powell, in this camp, when he wanted young people to come and participate, he did not offer a free camp where he invited people to come and enjoy the benefits. But he put a fee for participating, and at that same time, he made the fee different for people of different backgrounds. He charged a higher fee for those who could afford for it, and he charged less fee for those who were coming from difficult backgrounds or who could not afford to pay as the town boys could afford. Simply putting young people together was not his idea. He made a plan how to accommodate them, how their catering will be taken care of, how activities will be provided to them, and who all will help him in giving young people those activities which they required to do during the 9 days which he has originally planned for, from the 1st of August to 9th of August 1907. People today enjoy well-managed camps by event managers who put everything on the right place. People get down from their SUVs. Attendees carry their luggages, put them in the tents, and see that their comforts are taken care of. And people tell others that we enjoyed nature camp in high altitude. It may be Manali in India or Kunur or any place of their interest, and tell that we enjoyed the camp. But if you read how Lord Baden-Powell planned his camp at the very experimental stage, it's very worthy that he made it that everyone who attends the camp gets his life skill improved or some life skills learned. He put the boys into groups so that they take the leadership by their own. Maybe his experience in the Mafeking War period, when Colonel Edward Cecil put young boys into a boy brigade and made them under command, and how he achieved positive results by the initiatives of the young boys, was an intuition that young people will be worthy of leadership when it is given to them. I recall when we celebrated the centenary of scouting in 2007, we were looking to what scouting has given to the world. And it was rightly thought that scouting gave peace to the world as a gift. The gift the scouting could give to the world is really peace. If you think that when people from different backgrounds, especially when BP made it a point to bring young boys from different backgrounds to a camp for his experiment, it was really a thinking that people should start appreciating each other's advantages and disadvantages. Instead of bringing people from the same background or same economic situations, BP brought 22 boys from different backgrounds so that a peace is established between people having something and people having a little less. People should appreciate other person's difficulties and also understand their capabilities. The recent experiment of the scouting all over the world take us back to the Brownsea Islands experiment that Lord Baden-Powell made a point to bring a flagpole and the Union Jack, that is the national flag of the Great Britain, of United Kingdom of those days. Bringing a flagpole and a flag, it simply induces the spirit of one's patriotism, duty to his country. Every one of us, when we see our national flag, Tiranga, we are automatically induced to do something for our country. While bringing in the flag mast and the Union Jack to the camping ground, BP ensured that the first part of the scout promise, duty to country, is indirectly infused into the blood of the young people who were at Brownsea Island. BP prepared a good plan for layout of his camping area. He brought bell tents to accommodate the young people. He also arranged place for cooking and feeding in the campsite. Especially when you read this article, you will find that the tents were with platforms to sleep on. The scouts, they live a comfortable camping life, not a cozy camping life. It's not on the beds or quilts, but to have a little elevated platform above the ground so that when they take rest, they take proper rest so that they can participate in the programs actively. Lord Baden-Powell arranged resource persons from outside. He ensured that a commanding officer in charge of the coast guards near Plymouth or the Pearl Harbor was previously engaged with a specific purpose of training the young boys in first aid and firefighting. So, while planning the very first experimental camp, Lord Baden-Powell ensured that the scout camps does not become a place for simply merrymaking. Though Lord Baden-Powell had in his program regular campfires, games, and activities for young people during his experimental camp, he also ensured that the essential element of making a young boy skillful and to make him useful to his community or the family is achieved while they were with him in his camping. We should appreciate that while the young boys were under his command, he ensured that the command is with the young boys. He made them into groups, or what is later known as patrols, and the command of the boys were given to their leaders. The programs was so designed to give them enough of fun, enough of fight, and also to make their presence felt in their groups. Each one was given a responsibility, and every one of the boys who stayed in the camp could ensure that his personal ego is satisfied as an individual and he is being recognized as an important element among his friends in the group. The experimental camp as such paved the way for the publication of the Scouting for Boys, or originally BP called this as an handbook for citizenship training, into fortnightlies to be published in 6 fortnightlies, and could make the scouting a big success. Baden-Powell, while writing his programs, he made that all his experiences from the past is brought in. On your screen, you will see the Seas of Making, how it was a experiment for Lord BP to be used for the training of young people. He made it a success by providing leadership to young people instead of keeping the command of the experimental camp to himself. His experiences in India and also in the South Africa made him feel that if real leadership is given to the young people, that will work out better than the adults instructing them. BP always called scouting a game for young people under the guidance of adults. The adults need to guide young people on what they should do and what they should not, but not to instruct what they should do or what they should not do. The experimental camps of Lord Baden-Powell helped him to rethink and rewrite the content for the Scouting for Boys, which he originally written as a document for the members of the armed forces in the name of Aids to Scouting. This experimental camp also gave him a way forward to take his ideas
and his experiences in the past to be of use to this world, which has proved during last 113 years. Lord Baden-Powell always admired some symbols and things which he met while in India and Africa. Let's see, symbolically, Lord Baden-Powell tried to keep people together. Let's see, the scout uniform, what Lord Baden-Powell originally suggested was that of the South African Constabulary, which is like a local police. He appreciated them for the comforts and usefulness of the uniform, the knee-deep shorts, the hat which covers the head from the sun and the rains, and the smartness of wearing the stockings while participating in parades. Similarly, the kudu horn, which Lord Baden-Powell brought from Africa as a souvenir for himself, was used to call the first rouse of the sunrise camp at the Browns Island. The kudu horn, which is the horn of an antelope type animal, which is found in the African jungles, is one of the symbols that BP has brought to him, and it become a part of his camp's call. He used this kudu horn even later for the bigger gatherings of scouts, which is known now in the name of jamborees. Similarly, Lord Baden-Powell has brought with him the left-hand shake from the chief of the Ashanti tribe. Symbolically, when scouting was brought to young people, the positive elements or the stories of valor or stories of sacrifice or courage was what Lord Baden-Powell shared with the young boys. When Lord Baden-Powell thought of having the young people working, he always insisted that the young people work under their own command and not under the command of an adult. When we see the experiments what Baden-Powell has brought in is effective even today. The Court of Honor and Petroleum Councils that we practice in our scouting activities even today bring positive results, because young people take up the responsibility of their units. This leadership style worked well during this recent pandemic. We could see young scouts and guides, without the leadership of their unit leaders or their presence at their vicinity, were able to take up in big way producing the masks, which was very much needed for our community. Our young people made calls within their families, within their communities, to see that the protocols of hand wash, protocols of keeping distance is made. Their scoutmasters or unit leaders were not present. They were not there to tell them how to do it. But the leadership capabilities that they acquired while in camps and in the troop meetings made way forward to such an experiences. We have heart-touching stories about our rovers and rangers who were running community kitchens months together, which is an outcome of the leadership that has been caught by themselves. They acquired the leadership and the spirit of why they exist in the society and what they should do for their society at the time of need. We at the Bharat Scouts and Guides are proud of every one of them who are still working for more than 110 days to serve their communities in this pandemic. Let us recall, when we go back, how the experimental camp has contributed to the growth of scouting and the word peace that has become synonymous with scouting all over the world. And let us look forward on this day, the essential elements what Lord Baden Powell thought of. Number one, every scout camp must be contributory. Each one of us should contribute the cost of camping according to our economic backgrounds. In each camp, we should see that we make our own living areas, the tents. We should practice the life skills of cooking. And in every camp, we should learn something that can help us to contribute to the growth of our own personalities. We should also think of eliciting cooperation from more and more people who can contribute to the growth of scouting. From this experimental camp, we know how Lord Baden Powell has taken support of the owner of the land to establish his campsite, recruit people or people who could make contribution to his camp, his old friends from the army, the local resource persons, like who could contribute to teach the young people, who could help cook food for the young people, and to have the parents visit the camp as part of his program. He ensured that the children will be taken care of, their health, hygiene will be of his priority, and he also ensured that a proper accounting is made for all what he collects. We know the scouting principles. Two points of scout law are very important. Number one is scout is trustworthy. We should be responsible to whom we are drawing the resources. It can be money, it can be the tents, it can be the resources or the camping ground or place which has been given to us to be of use to the scouting guiding community. The last part is thrifty. Scout camps or events are not for showing our pride. It is to see that how we survive with the most bare resources and how best we can utilize them to best of the advantage of the young people, those who are in the camps. By all this, Lord Baden-Powell has set very high standards for scouts to have their camps and to have the scouting programs. Today, after 113 years of the scouting sunrise, on 1st August 1907, the world appreciates the efforts of Lord Baden-Powell in establishing the scout movement. The scout movement today is available in 171 countries and territories, united under the World Organization of Scout Movement, which operates from its registered office in Geneva and Central Operational Office in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, which is the secretariat of the World Scout Movement, of the World Scout Conference, and the executive body, the World Scout Committee. The World Scout Conference formulates the policies of program and adult in scouting, and also promote scouting to cater to the need of every young person who is in the age of scout age. For us, every young boy from the age of 5 years to 25 years is of the scouting age. And as Bharat Scouts and Guides, we strive to bring better scouting and also guiding to young people in this world. Let us all commit today that we promise to bring one more eligible person to the fold of the Bharat Scouts and Guides today, even remotely, while we celebrate the Scouting Sunrise Day today. I wish all in the scouting fraternity a safe time, and let's hope that the pandemic will give way as the clouds pass away on the time. When the time comes, let us all gear ourselves ready to serve the community physically, mentally, and especially emotionally. Please call your friends, those who are at home, whom you could not meet during last 4 months. Ask about their welfare. Remind them to keep physical distance, wash their hands, use masks when they go out of their homes, and also keep themselves fit when we come back, so that we can go back to yet another camping with our young friends and leaders when the time comes. Let's hope that this sunrise day of 1st August 2020 will open up new avenues for us to think how digitally we are connected and how we will be in touch with all others while we are at home. Thank you very much. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much, sir, for this wonderful demonstration and recitation of what was the first experimental camp. Though many of us would have read this, but when you talk and when you express these in the form of words, that makes a huge difference. Before we give the oath of thanks, now I request our State Chief Commissioner P.J. Sindhya, sir, for his closing remarks.
Thank you very much, Krishna Swamiji, for your narration of the first camp on the Brown Sea Island and the history of Scouts and Guides and the methodology which we have been adopting. Now, friends, I would like to make an appeal to each one of you. Today, the world is in a very big crisis. This pandemic is going to have effect on every country, on every human being, on the field of economy is going to have a drastic effect. On the educational field also, it is going to have a drastic effect. And also it will affect us socially also. From this pandemic, we have to learn lessons. At this point of time, Scouts and Guides all over the world, we are recognized for service. Scout is equal to service. Service is equal to scouting. There are many youth organizations working around the world for doing service. It may be Red Cross all over the world and many such organizations in various parts of this planet. But for Bharat Scouts and Guides in India, this is an occasion for all of us. The call of the hour is to do service. The call of the hour is to do service. We are meant for service. So by doing the service, let us all take the message of Baden Powell. Let us all take the message of scouting and guiding to every nook and corner of this country. When the service is needed, we have to do service. Wearing a medal of service is of no use. During the peacetime, anybody can do service. But we scouts and guides who are trained for courage, for conviction, for honesty, for discipline, this is the right time for us to do service. Not be in the hospitals. There are so many avenues where we can do service. Please sit at home. Talk to your friends. Talk to them about the COVID, how it is spreading. Talk to the COVID patients. They will get a lot of courage. From all the places, you run a counseling center. Counsel only one patient, two patients a day. Or their relatives. Their relatives, some of them have died of the heart attack. So run a counseling center from your place. Tell them what are the precautions they have to take during when they go out of the house to stop the spread of the COVID. There are so many things you can help the people. We have given a target of 1 crore masks to be prepared in Karnataka. It's going to be part of our life. It is very much essential that mask we have to wear. So you cannot prepare mask at home. You can give it to your friends and relatives. You can also sell masks at the production cost. You can also tell them about the other impacts of COVID on the educational field. Now the government of India has come out with a new education policy. We have holidays, maybe September, October, things may settle down. We cannot say that. So during this period, in our methodology, pertaining to the syllabus, which is going to be redefined as per the new education policy, it is necessary we also have to change. Change is a must. Change is a symbol of growth. So friends, this is the time to think. Think. Do service. This is all the appeal I have. I am very glad that our executive director, Mr. Krishnaswamy, gave a good presentation, narration about today's importance. I am sure we will do at least one good turn a day. We all do good turns every day, but today is a special day. So let us decide that we work hard, we work more service. With these few words, I have received reports from all the districts, from all parts of the country, the thousands of youngsters have renewed their scout promise. They have also decided to take oath to stop the coronavirus spread. I am very happy about all these things. I congratulate Mr. Madhusudan, who has given this activities back to the national headquarters. I congratulate him and his team. I also congratulate him for conducting this webinar in a very successful manner. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your beautiful, inspirational words. Friends, I know the day is just begun. The sunrise has just happened, and it's a long way to the sunset. If you have not yet started with your good turn, it is time for you all to think and just do one good turn. As rightly said by both the Krishnaswamy sir and PGR Sindhya sir, just call one friend whom you have not spoken for the last 6 months and check with them how they are doing. That can be one of the good turn. And any good turn you do, don't forget to share it with us. And there's a link which is activated for you all to get your digital certificates for your active participation for the day. Those links will be shared right now. These are the links. You can submit all your activities there and you can download your e-certificates. Thank you, one and all, for your time today. And let us celebrate Scouting Sunrise in a befitting way.